how did you like the new lineup and being at center, playing with those perimeter guys? How do you think that worked out?
Definitely had helps us spread the floor a little bit. I think we did pretty good for some time, and we're still experimenting, but we're gonna see if that works.
What do you think's been the thing that has dragged you guys down in the third quarter specifically? Seems like that's been the area where things haven't gone.
I mean, when our opponents are down at half, of course they're gonna try and have a reaction, but we gotta expect that every time, because our first half was pretty solid, especially defensively, you know. And there's ups and downs during the game, but we gotta get our downs less and less slow, you know.
Whenever you mentioned the offense, but when you're the big in that lineup defensively, how does that change your responsibilities from a defensive standpoint, from a rebounding standpoint?
It really depends on the game, because sometimes if I'm guarding the center, their center can be a shooter or not at all, or somebody that crushes the board every time. So it really depends on the game.
DeMar DeRozan was just talking about how one thing that a young team like you guys is missing is the ability to finish and have that guy who can close. Do you, 20 games into your rookie season, have you sort of noticed that's the missing part? How do you think you improve on that?
I think it's more of a team responsibility, you know. Our games don't often come down to the last minute or last second, you know. We just lose the lead or, you know, continuously throughout the second half. So, I don't know. I think it's just a maturity thing.
Yeah. Victor, I know the result is what you care about more, but you become the youngest player in NBA history to have a 20-20 game, 20 points, 20 rebounds. I want to get your thoughts on that.
I mean, as you said, it's, to me, it doesn't really have value if it's in a loss, but it's definitely an achievement. And I hope, you know, I can look back on it and think it as a good performance someday.
Trey said that, defenders have been physical as hell with you, and you've adjusted to that well, and also not looking to the refs for help or, you know, focusing on the calls. So is that something you've always been good at, or is that advice that someone's given you to zone that out?
He's talking about, like, not talking to the ref? And
yeah, not looking to them for calls and complaining a lot.
I'd say it's just my character. You know, I'm not trying to find excuses, and, you know, I find ways, and some guys are physical beasts, but quickness and, you know, smartness beats them. So there's many ways to counter that without complaining to the ref.
Do you think that teams are trying to be physical with you, trying to beat you up, or that's their game plan?
Yeah, of course. But, you know, this is what they've been doing. I mean, this is what I've seen my whole life, and it's nothing surprising so far.
Do you eventually want to be the closer for this team?
To end the games? I mean, it's a responsibility that comes naturally, I think. And, we've got many guys who can shoot the ball and who can make baskets, but it's, you know, we adapt it. Every game is different, every matchup is different, and we got to take advantage of it all.
Going back to the you playing some more five tonight, Pop mentioned a little while ago that he said absolutely when asked if that lineup, that's tonight's starting lineup, is something he's going to go with again or try again. You happy to hear that?
Have I heard it?
No. Are you? Does that make you? Is that something that you look forward to playing that five some more?
Of course, you know, experimenting different areas of the game. It's always something important and interesting to me, and it's. Yeah, you know, as I said, every game is different, but we're gonna see and try until we find a good recipe.
Thank you. We'll take some French. Go ahead. Victor, je sors complètement du basket pour parler de ta relation avec Jérémy, en fait. Je voulais savoir à quel point vous étiez proche. Est-ce que vous avez des habitudes ensemble, par exemple? Est-ce que tu aimes le plus chez lui? Je sais que vous êtes fans de foot tous les deux, par exemple, mais quelles sont vos habitudes ensemble en dehors du terrain?
Jérémy, je pense, je suis sûr que c'est le premier à m'avoir accueilli, avant même la draft et l'officialisation de mon arrivée aux Spurs. Et c'est aussi quelqu'un que j'avais rencontré il y a longtemps et avec qui on a des amis en commun aussi. Donc, c'est quelqu'un d'important pour moi dans cette équipe. Et bien sûr, on s'entend tous bien et on rigole, c'est un blagueur.
C'est un exemple de choses que vous faites ensemble en dehors du terrain?
Seulement nous deux, non, mais en équipe, ouais, on se retrouve souvent.
C'est la 16e défaite consécutive des Spurs, c'est une longue série de défaites de l'histoire de la franchise. Est-ce que ça te fait quelque chose et comment est-ce que tu arrives à garder ton mental compétitif justement dans cette situation?
Bien sûr que ça me fait quelque chose. Tout va bien dans ma vie, mais c'est le seul bémol pour l'instant. Bien sûr, c'est dur, bien sûr que je ressens des difficultés, mais je ressens jamais d'abattement. Et disons que faut être patient, il n'y a pas d'autre choix.